Good morning, friends, and welcome to Sunday School. We're so glad that you joined us this morning. We've still been missing y'all a whole lot, and we cannot wait for the day that we get back together and we're able to be in Sunday School and in church together again. So this morning, we have a story about someone who celebrates. Do y'all like to celebrate? I know I love to celebrate. And the man in this story has really good reason to celebrate. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to start off this morning by celebrating too. So we're going to have a little dance party. So what I want you to do is I want you to hit pause on this video, and I want you to get mom or dad to turn on a song that you love, and I want you to jump around, and I want you to dance, and I want you to just have a good time for a little bit, and let's celebrate the fact that we're gathering together for Sunday School. All right, take a minute and do that, and then come back and join us. Woo! Well, that was fun. I hope you had fun dancing with your family. And now that we've had time to celebrate, I need to ask you a question. Why do you think that people celebrate? Yeah, those are good answers. It could be that maybe they did great on a test, or maybe your team won a sports game, or maybe you're celebrating because it's your birthday. All good things to celebrate. What I want you to do, once again, is I want you to take a moment and I want you to hit pause and I want you to talk with your family about the way that you celebrate some things. I want you to talk about how you celebrate your birthday. I want you to talk about how you celebrate Christmas. I want you to talk about how you celebrated Easter just a few weeks ago. And maybe you have some other celebrations that you want to talk about. Take a minute, talk with your family, and talk about how you celebrate all of those special occasions, and then come back and join us. Did you think of some good ways that you like to celebrate? When we had Cam's birthday just a few weeks ago, we weren't sure how we were going to celebrate. But you know what? His family came together and they all drove by the house with presents and they got out with signs and we had such a good time celebrating his birthday all day long. Some of you might have had a birthday in the last few weeks and you might have had to celebrate that as well, but we can still find ways to have a fun time with our family. Maybe you also talked about Easter and how you celebrated Easter and celebrated the risen Christ. Maybe you had an egg hunt. Maybe you dyed some Easter eggs. I'm sure you did lots of fun things on Easter just a few weeks ago. We're going to get into our story in just a minute, but I first wanted us to start off with a prayer. But this is going to be a special prayer because I need your help with it. So for this prayer, I'm going to start it. And when I say we love to celebrate, I want you to shout out something that you love to celebrate. All right? So I'm going to point to you. And when I point to you, you tell me what you love to celebrate. All right? Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for giving us lots of reasons to celebrate. We love to celebrate. This is you. Go, tell me what you love to celebrate. Great job. Thank you for giving us the ability to feel joy. Amen. All right, for our next part, we're going to read our story together. Now, remember, I told you this story is about a man that has reason to celebrate. So it also has two of our disciples in it. So we're going to listen and we're going to try to see who those disciples are. And we're going to figure out why this guy has a reason to celebrate. Let's listen to the story.
Peter heals. At 3 o'clock one afternoon, Peter and John were walking to the temple to pray. Ahead of them, they saw some people carrying a man who could not walk. They carried him to the beautiful gate of the temple, laid him down, and left him alone. Because he couldn't walk, the man couldn't work, so he begged for money to buy food. When Peter and John walked up to the gate, the man asked, "Would you please give me some money for some food?" Peter said to the man, "Look at us. We don't have any money for you, but I have something much better. In the name of Jesus, I say, get up and walk." Peter reached out for the man's hand, and suddenly the man's feet and ankles and legs grew strong. With a happy cry, the man jumped up and started walking. He danced and skipped and hopped as he made his way into the temple with Peter and John. The man laughed and shouted and praised God. Peter and John had to move out of the way as the people from all over the temple were amazed and came rushing toward the man. Everyone was talking all at once. One man asked, "What happened to this man?" Another wondered, "Isn't this the beggar who can't walk and sits by the temple gate asking for money?" Someone else questioned, How has he been healed? Finally, Peter stepped in and said in a loud voice to the surprised crowd, "This man believes in Jesus, and his faith has made him strong. Right in front of you, he has been given a healthy body because he believes."
What a great story. So we see in our story that you have two of our disciples. We have Peter and John, and they're heading to the temple. But when they get there, they see a man that's laying up against a gate, and that man can't walk. And so he asks for help. And Peter and John, in the name of Jesus, they heal that man. What a wonderful thing. And what a great reason to celebrate. Now, one of the things that I wanted to focus on from today's story was Peter and John on their way to the temple. You see, when they were going to the temple, it says that they came upon a beautiful gate where the man was laying. Now, what I want you to do this morning is I want you to take a minute and I want you to think about what a beautiful gate might look like. Maybe it's gold, or maybe it's decorated with all sorts of stuff. So what I want you to do today is I want you to take a minute. I want you to get some paper, get some crayons, markers, colored pencils, whatever you might want to use. You can also get some decorations that you can use to decorate your gate. So here's what I want you to do. Here's my gate. I'm going to show you my gate. Mr. Bryant's not the greatest drawer, but this is the gate that I drew. Okay? What I want you to do is I want you to take a minute and I want you to decorate your own gate. Okay? And I want you to make it very beautiful as you can make it. Okay? So let's do that. Take a minute, make your gate, and then we'll come back together. I'm sure that y'all did a really awesome job with your gates. You know what? I would love to see your gates. So maybe your parents can text me a picture of it if they have my number, or I know they have my email address, so maybe they can email me a picture of your gates, because I'm sure that y'all did a wonderful job doing your gates, and I'm really, really proud of you. All right, I have two more things that we're gonna do today. One thing we're gonna do together, and then one thing you're gonna do on your own. All right, so here's the first thing that we're gonna do. What I want to do is I want to show you some pictures of people celebrating, and it's going to be your job to guess what they're celebrating. It's kind of like what we did a few weeks ago in Sunday school. So this is going to be really cool. You're going to see some pictures that pop up, and when you see those pictures pop up, I want you to yell out what those people are celebrating. And then when we come back, we'll discuss the answers, and I'm going to tell you the activity that you can do on your own. All right, let's do it.
Lord of all creation, of water, earth, and sky, the heavens are your tabernacle.
How'd you do guessing your celebrations? I bet you did an awesome job. All right, let's see what we did. The first one, that was a birthday. Our second one, that was St. Patrick's Day. People celebrating St. Patrick's Day. Our third one, that was Valentine's Day, yep. And our fourth one was the 4th of July. Good job. I bet y'all did awesome on that. Good job. All right, here's our final thing that I want you to do, and this is something that I can't do with you. You're gonna have to do it on your own or with your family. Because today in church, if we were in Sunday school, what we were gonna do is we were gonna help beautify our own gate. So we were gonna go outside of our church, and we were going to pick up and make sure that there was nothing out there and make it nice and clean and beautiful to look at. But we're not going to be in church this Sunday, so we can't do that. So what I want you to do is I want you to see if you can take a chance this week and you can help maybe beautify your neighborhood. Maybe you can go outside and pick up some litter. Maybe you can also go outside on your own front porch and make it look really, really nice. I bet you can do that. And that's something this week that you can do to help your neighborhood and help your family. That would be really awesome. So that's great. All right, well, we're gonna close out in prayer now. And I want you to know, when you leave Sunday school today, just how loved you are. We are missing you. We can't wait to see you again. We can't wait to be in church with you again today. So to end today in prayer, I'm also gonna need your help with our prayer, okay? And it's really easy because you only have to know three words. Hip, hip, hooray, all right? So when I point to you, I want you to say hip, hip, hooray, okay? Because we're celebrating in our prayer today. All right, let's go to God in prayer. Dear God, thank you for healing the beggar. Thank you for Peter and John and all of the people who spread your love. Help us to celebrate this week. Help us to spread love to everyone. Amen.